Welcome to the second episode on Padam Composers. In the previous episode, we saw about the life of Kshetrajna. Did you know that scholars are of the opinion that Kshetrajna was not one person but is a collective name? The songs sung by commoners who sang songs in particular themes as commissioned and also sang mangalams or benediction for generations of the family that commissioned them were compiled under a single name of Kshetrajna. This practice still exists among the Saniwaru or the existing erstwhile Telugu speaking courtesans of the southern regions. Many of these singers were remunerated or given manyam on each occasion, while some were employed in the services of the kings or lords and given udyam. With that interesting concept that makes us ponder a little about padams as a composition, we will now move on to today's composer, Sarangapani. As a pada composer, Sarangapani was a poet and composer who deserves great praise and recognition like Kshetrajna. He lived in the 17th century in the village of Karveti Nagaram in Andhra Pradesh. He was the Vidyadhikari or the Minister of Education in the court of Makaraju Venkata Perumal Raja. He was proficient in both Sanskrit and Telugu, and besides being a poet, he was well versed in music, dance and Natyashastra. His padams are in praise of Lord Krishna and bears the mudra Venugopala after his Ishtadevata. Many of his padams have come to be attributed inadvertently to Kshetrajna by substitution of the term Movagopala in place of Venugopala. Sarangapani's padams are, however, not as erotic as Kshetrajna's. Around 200 of his padams in palm leaf manuscripts have been discovered. They are similar to Kshetrajna's padam in terms of structure and musicality. In terms of theme, his padams have been classified by analysts into four categories: Shringara padams, Desiya padams, Jnana padams and Vairagya padams. Shringara padams like Alupu Jesi in Sensuality, Chitike Vesite in Kalyani, Ichina Manchide, Ivvakuna Manchide in Dhanyasi, Mandayanalu Gudi in Yadukula Kambodi, Pasaloni Dhara in Todi, to name a few. He has written some Desiya padams. For example, there is one talking of poverty where he says Venugopala must truly be so poor that he begged for rice flakes from Puchela in the padam Yanta Peddavade in Raga Mohanam. When he lost royal patronage and had to live the life of a commoner, he wrote Jnana padams like Agni Trirunalanta, Anjuni Kathalanta, being awed by the story of Mahabharata. And eventually, he also wrote Vairagya padams like Manusha, Nammaboke ee Dehamu Kalevaramu, which says, O mind, don't believe this body. It is just perishable skin and flesh. Among his Desiya padams, there is a very interesting one that portrays the travails of a woman who is married off as a naive child. She leaves the comfort of her parents' house with great dreams of enjoying life in the city, clad in dress sourced from Bandar, decked with jewels like anklets and toe rings, and carrying great wealth to be gifted to her in-laws. Alas, she is married to a man who is aggressive and torments her physically and emotionally. She bears it silently to uphold the name of the families until she can bear it no more. She ultimately becomes a Samanya, leaving behind her family. She then questions Venugopala as to how girls from good families can be held at fault for becoming wayward or for transgressing. How else could they sustain themselves? Padam Kulakantalu Vidabadinalu Dikkula Chelagieri Tirigieri Detti Papamu. Some of his padams have interesting features like interweaving names of herbs, ornaments, towns, trees, etc. in the Sahityams, as also the usage of Padaksharas and Nindastuti. For example, in the padam Varakanya in Gaulipanturagam and Jampatalam, he uses Shlesha Alankaram, that is, one meaning of the word will be an adjective to the beauty of the heroine, while the other is the name of a herb. Chandrodayam, a herb, is also describing the girl's face to be like a radiant moon. Her speech is like another herb, Drakshadi Rasam, and her character is like Chintamani, and she sings with Ananda Rasam. Sarangapani imparted instructions in Natya and Abhinaya to his contemporaries like Govindaswami and trained them as performers. He himself is known to have enacted the role of a lady to such perfection that on one occasion the Maharaja and the audience could not recognize him. Sarangapani has composed many padams that are also Nayaka based, one of them portraying an arrogant hero whose approaches are spurned by the heroine. We shall now have a glimpse of this padam in Ragam Kalyani, Chittike Vesite.
चिटके वेसिते नी वंटी चलुलु लक्ष पतिवेले चिटके वेसिते नी वंटी चलुलु लक्ष पदिवेले चिटके वेसिते नी वंटी चलुलु लक्ष पदिवेले चिटके वेसिते नी वंटी चलुलु लक्ष पदिवेले विडुकुलाडी एवडरुकुन्नावो वेणु गोपालुडु ना पेरु चलुलु लक्ष